I'm finding that God is raising up an army of people that are tired of the nonsense that's taking place in this nation, and they're ready to push back, and they're ready to go to war, and they're ready to get this country back, get our churches back, get our morals back. They're ready for it. And you're a testimony to that under this tent this morning. They call it the silent majority. We better quit being silent, church. We better stand up and stand out, speak up and speak out. You know, I'm convinced that it ain't even preaching time yet, but you've been here a while. Just humor me. I'm convinced a lot of pastors and a lot of people in the evangelical church, if it were going on way back when in the book of Daniel, I am convinced that a lot of those people would have told Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego to take a knee. Just kneel down before the culture. Just give in. Just close your church. Just give in to the mandates. Just put up with the... I am convinced that we have raised a generation of cowards. And the problem is, the reason we have so many popsicles in the pew is because we've got far too many polar bears in the pulpit and men of God not standing up and saying, enough is enough, ladies and gentlemen, enough is enough. So here we are. And not only is this just a glorious time of revival in the life of our body and the life of our church and the life of people that have come from literally all over the country every single week, but I'm telling you, as you'll hear in just a moment, both for us, for Roger and his team, and for what's about to take place, this is a historic event right here.
So there is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. Yeah. To break every chain, break every chain. Break every chain.
Declare and say,
to break every chain. Break every chain. Break every.
Now somebody lift your hands in the air right here.
See, there's an army.
Woo! We won't keep silent. Say,
there's an army.